गोपिका जीवन स्मरण गोविंदा गोविंदा सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। राम राम हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे। कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे।
गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। कलये सुन्दराकारं सदैकप्रियदर्शनं अज्ञाननाशकं देवं सद्गुरुं गुरुवीन्द्रम्। सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। I begin by first offering my humble prostrations at the lotus feet of my Guru Maharaj, our Guru Maharaj, His Holiness Sri Sri Muralidhara Swamiji, because of whose boundless grace and blessings I'm here today. I would like to offer my pranams to every one of you, all your friends and bhaktas who have come here. And I believe that by blessing me with this opportunity to come here today to be in your midst on this momentous occasion of inauguration of the Kuala Lumpur God Satsang Center, more than anything else, Sri Swamiji has blessed me with the opportunity to meet wonderful people like you, and I really, really thank you for that and welcome you officially to the center on behalf of this organization. I wish to thank Sumandra here who introduced me, but the one introduction that I really feel proud about is that it's not about the medical, the degree or all these accomplishments, but the one single moment for me to be proud about really is that my Guruji accepted me to do the seva that he has given me. If he wished to be done by anybody, but he gave me this wonderful opportunity to do it, and that is really one thing that I feel very proud about, and not anything else. So, it's purely His grace and His blessings that has given me this wonderful opportunity. Before we actually begin, a brief word about all these wonderful people, devotees of Guruji, who have been responsible for this center itself. Although everything happens, as we know, by the grace of God, no doubt about that, everything has to happen from that end. He has to wish for it. But that grace has to work through somebody. It has to work through some people. That's how normally things happen. And in that way, that seed of bhakti, that seed of love, that seed for this Maha Mantra in this center here was sown through our beloved Premalataji, known to all of you as Dr. Julie Tang. And Premalataji is a name given to her by our Guru Maharaj. So that's where it started, when she first had darshan of our Guru Maharaj years ago, when I met her first when she came from Russia. And we also need to remember Jagdish Prabhuji, who brought her to Guruji. He's much loved by all of us in our ashram, a very, very pure and humble soul. And he brought her to Swamiji. And then from her, she passed it on to our beloved Rajeshwariji, and then Nathanji. And that's how these three wonderful people have been responsible for all of this, for all of this. The grace of the Master is really working through them, and I was so moved when I came here 2 days ago to see all these wonderful children, this nice center, and the kind of love that these three people have seemed to be having for our Guru Maharaj and this whole cause. So I offer my pranams to the three of them, because but for them I think this satsang would not have commenced. Look at life itself at large. If we step out of this tiny room that we are sitting in now and just take a look at the wide world that is around us, the one thing that strikes us first, the one thing that we find is common to all living forms is the scientists would call it, because from the science that I was trained in, you call it the will to survive. The will to survive is one thing that keeps all of life going. Everybody wants to survive. But our saints, our scriptures, our Guru Maharaj would say that it is the pursuit of joy, the pursuit of happiness, that is really what keeps life going. I will explain how. It's very simple. If you take the example of a tiny ant, this ant is always running after the sugar crystal, after the sweet. Because if you leave sweet open anywhere, you find a line of ants lining up to take that sweet. Because the ant believes that it is going to get that joy and that sweet and that sugar crystal. You find the birds always flying in search of something, and you find that the bees are always after the honey. And if you take man, the most blessed, sophisticated, evolved creation of God, we are also constantly after something or the other in life. That is really what keeps that going. We may be after education, we may be after wealth, we may be after position, we may be after love from family, from friends. That search is really what keeps our life going itself. Because we believe that we are going to find that happiness in all of these things, in education, in wealth, in power, in family, in friends. That is really what we are after ultimately. End of the day, we all want to be happy. Even the man who is doing a wrong act is doing it because he wants to be happy. So that search for happiness is really what is driving all life itself. That is the beauty of the whole thing, of course. When we say happiness, when we say joy, actually the very beautiful word for this is the one in Sanskrit which is called ananda, because the difference between English and Sanskrit there is that for ananda there is no opposite. When you say joy, there is always sorrow. When you say happiness, there is always sadness. But for Ananda, it's just Ananda, it's bliss.